one Sunday, our pastor at the time did a sermon on tithing. And it was one of those days when we just felt like he was talking directly to us. It's extremely convicting. And it just didn't make any sense. You know, we really thought we'd lose our house if we took that kind of a step. But we felt just so convicted by God's Spirit. And we decided to tithe. I can remember the moment when we made that decision, and just this peace came over to me, even though we fully expected the consequences to be ugly. but they weren't. We didn't lose our house. We had a baby. Our David was born less than a year later, and I took a leave off work and never went back to work. We started to build a new house in Monticello, and I just can't explain it, except it was kind of, I've called our Malachi 3. There's a verse that talks about bringing the whole storehouse to God and test me in this. You know, God asking us to trust Him and test Him and see if He doesn't pour out blessing. And it was a miracle. You know, it was incredible.
For me, I used to worry a lot more about money. And, once you made a decision to put it the priority where it belongs and realize that everything we've gotten is from God, just giving back a piece of, that He's already given to us, became a lot less worrisome, and keep our priorities trying to do God's work and what God's calling us to do.
You know, it seems like God's just taught us to really hold on to stuff loosely. It's not that important. And for us, our cabin isn't that important. Our house isn't that important. We're really not sure what it looks like in the future, but what we want to make sure that we're set for is that we can move as God's calling us to move, and that we have hopefully been wise in stewarding that and preparing. You know, our hope is that we've built in margins so that we can allow that to grow and really make an impact for God's kingdom. It really is.